to these moments. With that airtight hatch closed and the capsule secure,
Astronaut Stray, how do you read me?
Stray is good. Bobby, 4.
They were ready for blastoff.
2, 1.
Mission control has confirmed New Shepard has cleared the tower. Our original of their lives right now. A huge congratulations to all 6 crew. They have crossed that Kármán line and they became official astronauts.
So they are weightless now.
Just more than 10 minutes after liftoff, the capsule making its way back.
3 beautiful main parachutes.
Landing safely back on Earth.
So keep in mind here, there we go. Touchdown.
Monumental experience.
And you were my always there one.
Amy catching up with Michael on the ground.
You realize how small you really are.
Just see the curvature, the atmosphere, blue, the earth. Just, it was too short.
So what's next for our colleague turned Blue Origin astronaut?
Astronaut Stray going to the moon next?
Yes. If they invite me, I'm going to the moon. And I'm going to walk and talk.
Yeah, he's got that moonwalk down. He's got that moonwalk down. He sure does. And listen, he told Amy he is ready to go back to space. But just think about this. Just 609 people have now been to space. And our guy Stray is one of them, Will.
Wow, Gio, that is a low number. What a week for Strahan and for you covering it all. You did a great job. Thank you for being our eyes and ears on the ground there. Very exciting stuff for our colleague and friend Michael Strahan. But let's get some more insights into the whole journey from someone who knows a lot about space. It's former NASA astronaut and ABC contributor Katie Coleman. She's one of those 609 people. She's logged 159 days up there. Welcome, Katie. Thank you for being here. And at first, Michael was hesitant about going to space. Now he says he wants to go again, this time to the moon. How does a journey to space change your perspective?
Months there, I would have spent another 6 months in a minute. And it's partly, it's just so amazing to sort of be in a different world and feel like a pioneer. And even in that 3 minutes, I think that that transformation happens. And just, I think it actually opens up the possibilities of who we are and where we live. You see everyone below you. And you know, if only they could be connected, we could actually figure out anything.
Everybody seems to be overcome when they look out that window. They see Earth and all that it contains down way below. What is it about that image that's so powerful?
I think it's the fact that you realize that everyone is down there. And I thought when I left Earth and went to space, I'd be going. But really, you're still part of Earth. I mean, that's still home. You're still there. You feel connected. And yet you also see that there are many, many of us, and the Earth is, I mean, that's our home, and it's a place we need to take care of. And I really think that it just makes people, it puts things in perspective, what is big, what is small, and what we've got to do.
Now, what does this indicate for the future of space travel?
Well, these flights, they may seem like, well, what could you do in 3 minutes? But that 3 minutes, I mean, even yesterday we saw how important that was to Michael. It opened up his point of view and what he sees as his possibilities for making a difference. And also, I would say, just from what I heard, you know, for the ABC family, for everyone that cares about him and knows him and works with him, they now look at those possibilities differently as well. So there's a real ripple effect of being able to see someone that looks and feels like you or that you know and you care about. When they go, you go with them. So even though, you know, you say 609, there's a lot of ripple effect of how many people those 609 bring with them. But also, that 3 minutes is astonishing as a science platform. I mean, right now it's either go to the space station and do experiments, or we've got a zero-G airplane where we can have about 30 seconds of that weightlessness to figure out what experiments to bring to that space station. And so by having 3 minutes to do that kind of science.
It really is fantastic. And thank you so much, Katie Coleman. about possibility. It's Michael Strahan, guys. Really awesome.
I love what you said there about perspective. What is big, what is small, and what we've got to do. We'll be right back. Yeah.